Welcome to Heart of the Passion, the Pittsburgh Passion Football Show that will give you all the highlights and give you an in-depth look to all things Pittsburgh Passion Football. I'm your host, Matt Fargo. Before we take a look at what has already happened during this 2015 season and what is to come, we had to take a look back at 2014 when the Pittsburgh Passion captured the IWFL World Championship in Rock Hill, South Carolina. There comes an expectation playing in the City of Champions, and it's an expectation that doesn't need an explanation. For the energy in a side car to the left, back to pass, looking right and throwing that way. Pass is intercepted, picked off at the 50-yard line. Got the 30, got the 25, the 15. No one's going to catch her. Touchdown, Pittsburgh! And going all the way is Michelle Peters. She takes it all the way for a steal and score. The Passion get on the board defensively. It's a 50-yard intercept. Second down and nine. Back rolling out is Hordage. She's going to let it fly. Got a receiver. It's Angela Baker, who makes one miss, spins off another, and she's down into the Silver Sports Silver Zone. Second down and long, throwing, and it's intercepted. Sharon Bangway, she's going down the sidelines and out of bounds. Another takeaway by the Passion defense. It's Sharon Vasquez, and the Passion get another big play by the defense, and it will be a first and 10 Pittsburgh, and a play action. Flag came flying in. Gordon will step and throw. Long got her receiver. That is Angela Baker. Tight rope at the far side. From that 43. Rolling out is Horton. Going to stop and let it throw. Got Wadowski down the far sideline. It's caught. Rachel with the move and tiptoes and just ended up.
Work on the field.
It's Chick off the left side, cutting back, got some blockers, 15, 10, stiff arm, end zone, touchdown, Pittsburgh, Sierra Chick. for the Pittsburgh touchdown of 23 yards.
Thank you.
Passion co-owner Franco Harris might know a thing or two about expectations as a rookie, but so do the Pittsburgh Passion rookies. Passion brought in over 20 rookies to the 2015 season, and it only took two plays into this season for one of them to make a direct impact. Tara Catone laced up her cleats and put on the pads for the very first time in Toledo, Ohio, and the result wasn't something that even Franco Harris could claim. Her first two carries of her career went for touchdowns. To Heart of the Passion, presented by UPMC Sports Medicine. Pittsburgh Passion opened up their 2015 home schedule against Philadelphia. And a lot has happened in the Pittsburgh-Philadelphia sports history scene, but maybe for the first time, Pittsburgh was wearing orange, and it was for a good reason.
And lost the fight in early 2011. The quality and number of treatments for MS has improved greatly since 1984. It is through fundraising events like the MS Walk that these advances have been made possible. Says Lisa, he was my biggest fan and loved the Pittsburgh Passion. I still look up in the booth at Couple Stadium and can see him there smiling each and every time I take the field. Ladies and gentlemen, Lisa Horton for her father, John.
They took away our run in some cases, so you know we have multiple weapons outside as well. So they gave us eight in the box, so we decided to spread it out and throw it around. A lot of great blocks and pickups. So I mean, that's all our team doing that.
What is it like to have such an arsenal? You have folks that can play both sides of the ball. They shut down one aspect of the game. You have others that you can rely on. What sort of confidence does that give you?
Oh, tremendous confidence. I mean, that just makes us, you know, we're multidimensional. If they're going to take a right way to run, then we go with our pass game. Last week we had a great run game, and we were able to run all day. So it's really a blessing, and we have a special group that can play multiple positions as well. So.
And what about these rookies? I mean, it's probably the most rookies we've had on the pass in a long time. They've been coming out and making a
difference. Yeah, they're making a huge difference. And you know that last play, Krosi took that ball, that pick six. That was amazing. I mean, we have a lot of rookies. We have over 20, 25 rookies this year alone. So they're picking up the game. They're picking up the way we roll and the way we set the bars. And we have a lot of great athletes. So I look forward to years to come and see what happens, you know, as they develop.
Now tonight, special night.
Overwhelming.
What was it like? I mean, you know your dad's up there smiling down, prouder than ever.
Yeah.
He was a fixture in the stands for years. We all loved him. Thought he was one of our own.
Tonight was amazing. It was just amazing, special. It's been 12 years, like, to do something like this. I mean, the thought was there, back in February, I was like, hey, I knew the MS Walk was coming, but it really affects more people on our team. You know, Mrs. Niedermeyer and BT. So our ability, and that's what we do. Like, we take a cause and, you know, we create hope around it. And this, and MS just affects a lot of people on our team, and it was the right thing to do this year. So to see that and see the overwhelming, like, support and the orange, and it is like a dream come true. I saw this years ago, but, like, to see it happen and the smiles and, across the board, that was amazing. And the Facebook stuff, and that kind of just blew up. Kudos, a lot of my teammates, a lot of work went behind the scenes on that. I did not do anything but just tell our story and kind of had the idea, but our team, they did amazing running with us. Really, made it a really special night for my family as well.
Keeping it community focused.
Yeah.
More than just about playing football and being part of their passion.
Our team is more about football. I think everyone knows that. But that was the message tonight. Like, tonight, like, really created a lot of hope for, PT and just me and Myron. See their smiles and to know that they have support, that's what's important. They're not alone.
Pittsburgh Passion continued their 2015 season against the New York Sharks. The Sharks came in undefeated, as did the Passion. And while the two teams battled it out on the field to remain undefeated, what stole the show at Couples Stadium on the south side was a salute to those who serve. message through sports. I'd like to thank all the friends, family, and sponsors that make that mission possible. On behalf of owners Franco Harris and Teresa Kahn, we hope to see you at a game soon. Until next time, I'm your host, Matt Fargo. Thanks for watching. How your business can get involved with the Pittsburgh Passion, visit PittsburghPassion.com.